Once again, it's indeed an honor for me to have the opportunity to recognize Workers' Memorial Day in Pennsylvania, as well as Wilkes-Barre Labor Council's 12th annual service honoring the memories of workers who died on the job. Every year on April 28th, we observe Workers' Memorial Day, a day of mourning that is conducted annually. Many conduct services locally, of course, on a statewide basis, as a country, and yes, around the world. An International Day of Remembrance, a day to honor workers killed, disabled, injured, or made unwell in the workplace. Coinciding with the Occupational Safety and Health Care Act of 1971, this day should serve both as a reminder of the dangers our workers they face each and every single day in our Commonwealth and around the country. After a year filled with challenges brought on by the global pandemic, it is important that we remember those who have lost their lives on the job and work tirelessly to improve workplace safety. Just as our workers labor day every day to provide essential infrastructure, goods and services to Pennsylvanians in good times and bad. I want to extend a special thank you to all of our frontline workers, our healthcare providers, the doctors and nurses who are fighting this war to save lives and protect all, while putting their own lives on the line. They, along with our grocery store workers, truck drivers, bus drivers, farmers, producers, and so many others who are providing the goods and services we need every single day. We must never forget those who paid the ultimate sacrifice while working in the past, and never forget those who continue to serve and protect us each and every day. According to the United States Bureau of Labor Statistics, 5,330 workers made that sacrifice in the United States in 2019. A 2% increase from 5,250 workers we lost in 2018. In our very own state, 154 Pennsylvanians lost their lives in work-related incidents in 2019, down from 177 recorded in 2018. That's 154 husbands or wives, sons or daughters, parents or grandparents, who went to work one day and never returned home to their families again. Today, I also want to honor the Greater Wilkes-Barre Labor Council for their annual Workers' Day Memorial. This program brings together over 40 different individual unions and their members as they pay tribute to their fellow workers that suffered death or injury in northeastern Pennsylvania. In addition to honoring those injured or killed, the Wilkes-Barre Labor Council continues to endorse procedures that prevent workplace tragedies and improve the health and safety of every worker. Like them, it's important to remember those who have lost their lives and to work tirelessly to improve that workplace safety. As our workers labor every day to provide essential infrastructure, goods and services to Pennsylvanians and provide a quality standard of living for their families, honoring Workers' Memorial Day sends a sincere message to our workers, their families, and their employers that we care and we expect the highest standards of safety to be followed in PA. Again, Mr. Speaker, I thank you very much. And to everyone that is supporting Pennsylvania's Worker Memorial Day, the Wilkes-Barre Labor Council, and the Worker Safety Program in Pennsylvania. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.